room to work. I think it may be just harder because the solder's there. Yeah. Because it opened. That's just a very hard plastic. Trying not to rip any of these other wires out. Or trash the light. Jeez. Man, that's just weird plastic, hard as a rock. Okay, this stuff looks like it should just come right on. Need to pay attention where everything's at. I should probably tape that or mold it together somehow. This is just some of that stuff that does a lot of different things. One of them will be. To keep these wires together until I can see what's going on. Obviously, I need to find some more wire here. Because this has nothing coming out. And that is so tiny. Let's see. Alright. I give up. Where'd you go? No. Jeez. What I'm doing is I'm gently applying pressure while turning it. Just trying to do what a pair of wire strippers would do. Now, I have a pair in the garage, but I don't think that they would even be I don't think that they would even be small enough . See, I'm cutting into that and I could feel hitting the wire, which is really not what I want to do. Poop, yep. It's such a fine wire. All right. Let's try it one more time here. How you want to do this? I say we try the blade. While kind of rolling it. Yep. I'm certainly not getting that on film. Alright, so I'm trying to roll the wire. And cut through the plastic enough to strip it off, but not cut it too much. Like I think I just did. There we go. Success. All right. No. Let's do a dry fit here and see if just touching this to that is what's going to be needed. Again, I'll get some of this little putty stuff. I don't know what else to call it. It's not clay, but I'm sure there's a name out there somewhere. Let me just twist this end. I'm dealing with these tiny wires, whew, can be a challenge. Can be a real challenge. Alright. Let's see if that does. Hey, look. Oh boy. Now, wait a minute. Wait. There we go. Boom. They all work. Awesome. So that was a dry fit. Now I gotta solder that wire in there. Now this I'm gonna have to probably raise up a little here, because I have to get my tool in here. This is actually the Ryobi battery operated. I've used it once before, and it worked pretty well. So, I'm gonna use it again this time. And we'll see how it goes. So take this off. What we're probably gonna do is just move it down I'll probably move it down to like there. So I can set it up a little more. And then what I'll do is probably pull one of these out. Looks like I may have to pull that up. Give me some extra room. Whoop, whoop, whoop. I'm trying to set this in such a way so when I go to solder, I get the least amount of movement. It's going to be a little finagling. So that's what it's looking like. That's laying on top of a bead of solder. Whoa. And there we go. So laying on top of a bead of solder. Well, it was until it just crushed it. Now I gotta fix it. Oh, all just to get it on. Hey, just to record it. Yay. Here's the problem, is I can't see the solder. It's gonna be a little tricky because that solder wondering if I should solder, because it's encased in plastic. It's a very thin bead of solder in there. Right in there. A very thin bead of solder. And this part is all plastic. So it's like, I'm gonna have to get it almost perfect. That's no bueno. I'm wondering if I should use hot glue. I'm wondering if hot glue would do the trick. Why isn't the other side working? Oh, I'm confused. Wait a minute. Why isn't this other side working? What? There we go. Okay, it just wasn't touching it at all. Oh, that's gonna be tricky. I do have a little more solder. No flux. But a little bit of solder. was nothing. I'm wondering if I should switch hands. Look how quick that looked. See how quick that melted that plastic? Holy moly. My finger. That should work. Yep. Put the soldering iron up here. Got a little tangled mess. Ew. What I'm doing now is I'm trying to I think I'm gonna shrink wrap that with one of these. The tiniest one I could find. I should have done was put it on before. Yeah. Well, I could put one of these bigger one on. I think it'll fit over that. Yeah, but if I bend that thing's gonna break. Okay. Bad mistake. What I did is I forgot to put the shrink tube on first and slide it down here out of the way. Put this together and then pull it all the way up. So I could slice the shrink tube. get it on. Yeah. I gotta do that. I gotta get some kind of cover over it. Otherwise, it's gonna end up pulling apart. One little tug, and it'll pull apart. And I don't think I'm gonna need a big old giant piece like this. Cut it right about there. Slit one end and see if I could somehow finagle it on there. Eek. I'm bending the light. All right. Which one is it? All right. I used to set of matches around here. With a small candle. I found a small candle. But I don't see the matches anywhere. Sorry, folks. Good thing about this blue stuff is you could rip it into a million pieces. Ooh, easy. Hey, Nathan? Can you do me a favor? Oh, wait, there might be one down here. I think there's a lighter down here for the candles. Never mind. All right. So, this damn slit. It defeats the whole damn purpose. Now I gotta take it off. Because what I've done, it's created no type of barrier. And that will protect it. So let's put it back together. I just tested it. All the lights are working. All the lights are working. So, what we'll do is put it back together slowly and carefully. So as not to disturb any of the wires. Sorry, put the battery back on the charger. and making sure I got these in the order that they came in. So this one here, this is the broken one. I have to figure out. I think I'm going to come back up this way. See how much wire we got left. Because when they assembled this in China, I don't think they put much thought into it, but when I have to put it back together here in America, I have to give some thought to it. Why is that? It's like the Yeah. Well, hopefully that works. There you go. Bada bing. So, turning it over. Happy 4th of July. There you go. All right. Very good. All right, happy 4th of July. Boom.